Hello, everyone. My name is Ricardo Carrillo Cruz. I work as a cloud automation engineer at Hewlett Packard. My team runs a CI infrastructure that is based in OpenStack Infra, which is used to build Helium OpenStack and quite a few other cloud products. So the topic about this talk is how to deploy an OpenStack Infra with Ansible. What are the use cases to deploy a testing OpenStack Infra? So one of the use cases is to test and debug OpenStack bugs of OpenStack Infra itself. So maybe you found a bug in OpenStack Infra and you need an environment to test and troubleshoot. So it would be good to have a quick and easy way to get a testing OpenStack Infra. Another use case could be demo installations to test OpenStack Infra capabilities. This is for organizations that they would like to have CI infrastructure. They would like to see if OpenStack Infra fits their needs. And another use case could be testing upgrades of OpenStack Infra components. So this is for organizations that already have an OpenStack Infra CI, and they would like to test thoroughly upgrades of key components, like, for example, Garrett or Zool, which are very key to the whole functionality. So how Upstream manages its own infrastructure? So the configuration of all systems for Upstream OpenStack Infra is stored in a source repository that is called systemconfig. This repository is written in Puppet. It contains quite a few of Puppet modules. And the environment configuration values are stored in Hira. They're not kept into systemconfig. So the reason for this is that you do not want to put sensitive information like SSH keys or SSL certificates into a public repository. So that's kept completely separate in private. So you may think you could just use systemconfig to deploy your own OpenStack Infra. That's kind of a problem. It is hard to consume systemconfig, and these are the reasons. So systemconfig contains a mix of Puppet modules and environment-specific configuration, host names, domain names, email addresses, usernames that are very specific to the Upstream infrastructure. The manifest often contain hard-coded values that are specific to Upstream. And they don't usually have test mode flags. Maybe with the exception of the Garrett manifest, you don't have an easy way to bring up any infra service with a snake or certificates, without backups, an easy way to consume that in a testing environment. So to put it in a nutshell, so systemconfig is not downstream consumable. So this is the reason why I started working on Infra Ansible. So what is Infra Ansible? So it's a set of Ansible playbooks to deploy a minimal OpenStack Infra for testing purposes. I would like to highlight that this is for testing. It's not meant for production whatsoever. It's for kind of a developer environment. It uses the new OpenStack Ansible modules, if you are familiar with them. They're starting to merge into the dev branch of the Ansible repository. So that's to have InfraAnsible kind of future-proof. And also, I use Ansible for provisioning the infra instances and orchestrating the deployment. I don't use Ansible for the config management. The reason is because we already have in systemconfig and OpenStack Infra namespace Puppet modules for pretty much everything, so there's no need to reinvent the wheel. They're tested, they work, so I just use them. So how Infra Ansible works? So you define in a YAML file your OpenStack Infra stack. You would put some global values that are specific to your environment, like what's your domain name, what's your key name to deploy instances in your OpenStack cloud, the location of the systemconfig git repo in case you have a fork and you do not want to use the Upstream repo. Once you have That YAML file, which also contains a stanza for each of the servers for the OpenStack infra, like you would have a stanza for NotePool, Garrett, so on and so forth. Each stanza would contain information about how to bring up those instances, like what flavor, what glance image, what host name, that kind of stuff. Once you have all that small YAML file, you kick off the provisioning for service playbook. This step, what it does, it will go through all your stanzas for your servers, and it will create an instance for each one of them. So once that step finishes and you have all your instances created, then you run the site.yaml playbook. This is the whole myth of InfraAnsible. This is what kicks off the whole orchestration. The way it works, it deploys a system config into the Puppet Master with a tailored site PP that is specific to your environment, which you defined previously in the YAML file. Then it generates the bare minimum hierarchies and values for your servers, SSH keys, SSL certificates, so on and so forth. Then it bootstraps a Puppet Master installation. It makes all servers except of the Puppet Master to request a certificate against the Puppet Master. Then the Puppet Master signs those certificate requests. And finally, it runs a Puppet agent minus test to configure every service with the pertinent Puppet modules. So the present and immediate feature of InfraAnsible. So InfraAnsible is currently a work in progress. Right now it works, it deploys the Puppet Master, Jenkins, Garrett, and Zool. I'm currently working on NotePool, and then I would say that would be kind of the first stage of InfraAnsible, because that's the bare minimum for OpenStack infra. I'm hoping to move it from my local GitHub to StackForge this week to get people from OpenStack to contribute to it, probably put some tests. And I would also like to propose it for system config and or the Puppet OpenStack CI projects, because I believe that InfraAnsible can be really handy for doing integration testing. Because right now system config and the Puppet modules that that uses, we only have unit testing, but we do not have integration testing. So I think that could be very useful here. So here's the URL for the InfraAnsible repository. You can find me as Arcarito Cruz on OpenStack Infra Channel. I am pretty much there pretty much all day. These are my contact details, my email address, my Twitter handle. In case you have any questions, I will be happy to answer, help you out. I'm looking to hear from you soon. Thank you.